further, let me tell you one thing. So earlier, it was two separate courses. Okay, actually, it was one course called AC. AC means analog communications. It was in third year, first semester. So there is another course called DC. Means what? Digital communications. It was in third year, second semester. But so what they have done is they have mixed these two and they are calling now it as ADC. So for your batch, for your seniors, so these two courses combined and they made it ADC. Actually, we are studying two subjects at a time. Is it okay, all of you? So earlier, these were two separate courses, analog communications and other one is digital communications. But so they merged these two and they made it as a ADC. Okay. So now let me write one thing. Now here we have a huge syllabus. The syllabus is very, very huge because almost we are studying two subjects at a time. So that's why I need your complete attention to complete the syllabus within time. Okay. So I request everyone to study the syllabus time to time. Don't think that I will study at the end of the semester. You cannot study like this because it is very huge syllabus. As I told you just now, we are mixing two subjects and we are making it as a single subject. So that's why I request everyone to follow the syllabus regularly and study time to time. Okay. And one more thing. So here I may not discuss more problems just like PTSP course because we don't have enough time to complete the syllabus itself. I may not discuss that many problems as expected. So one more request is please take any textbook or any computer exam question papers, try to solve problems on your own. So from my side, I'll try to solve as many problems as possible, but we don't get enough time to solve the more problems. Okay, that is one more request from my side. Okay, now so keep in this mind. So we are studying analog and digital communications. Okay, so this is about this course. Now, so let us start now. This is the syllabus. The first one is analog communication. So this unit itself is a course, actually, more or less. The first unit of this course itself is another course. What is that? Analog communications. Or otherwise, you can simply say first two units or one course. Earlier, the first unit and second unit combinedly called as a course called analog communications, which was in third year first semester. So remaining three units, so they were called as another course, separate course name as digital communications. So which means they're studying two subjects in one semester at a time. Okay, so I don't want to waste much time. Now let me go to the bibliography. So we have two famous textbooks. So this is Modern Digital and Analog Communications by B.P. Lathi. It's a very, very famous textbook. Another textbook. This is predominantly for analog communications. So we have digital also, but more or less it is very useful for analog communication. So the next one is Simon Atkins. Okay, it is predominantly for digital communications. You must refer these two textbooks. They are very good textbooks. And apart from that, I mentioned some URLs for your reference. They are NPTEL videos. Okay, so if you have time, you can go through these videos also. But so please download these textbooks. They are available in the internet. So I will try to upload in the LMS. So everybody should have these two textbooks with you. Okay, what is that? B.P. Lathi and Simon Atkins. Right. So, shall I start now? Should we wait for others to come? So, still only 15 students are online. So, please ask your friends to come and join. So, if this is the case, how can you go online? I'll wait for 5 minutes. So, as I told you, one more thing. Please read the please read the prerequisites. You know what is prerequisite means? Prerequisite
Basics.
for these subjects. What are the two subjects that are required to study this subject? I told you yesterday, I messaged you know. That is S&S.
SEC probability.
S&S and probability. One must aware of the basics of S&S and probability to understand this course. Okay. So I request one more time, please go through the basics of signals and systems and as well as probability theory. So probability theory you can read later, but so urgently we need the basics of S&S, at least for the first and second units. So later you have to study about PTSP. So what I am thinking is, anyway, you have studied PTSP in the last semester only. You might be remembering everything, at least basics. But S&S, you might have studied in your second and first semester, right? So by this time you might have forgot it. So that's why I request everyone to go through the basics of S&S first. Is it okay? So without S&S, you cannot do anything here. And not only that, you need basics of not probability, stochastic process. We basically we need the basics of stochastic process as well as signals and systems. Okay, that is must. Now, so is everything okay with you? I mean, all are safe or not? Okay. So this is the first unit. So that is, let us study the analog communications. Okay. So basically, signals are two types. Okay. What are they? Analog signal and digital. What is analog signal? It is again two types. What is that? Continuous time and discrete time. And this is a digital signal. Okay. So, how to convert continuous time to discrete time? What do you do?
Sampling, sir.
Sampling. This is sampling. Okay. So now how to convert? Okay, first of all, so what is the difference between discrete time and digital signal? Do you know?
Continuous in amplitude and discrete in time,
Which one? Which one?
whereas discrete time signal,
Yeah.
whereas digital is quantized in amplitude?
Yeah, in the you are right. So simply is it is discrete in both. Discrete in what? Amplitude as well as time. So this is only discrete in time, not in amplitude. So it is continuous in both time and amplitude. This is continuous in amplitude, discrete in time. Whereas the digital signal is what? Discrete in both time and amplitude. Okay. Now, what does discrete means? What do you mean discrete?
It any have values like at integers.
Need not be integers.
Not continuous.
Actually. Need not be integers. We say integers, but it could be anything actually. It is a finite set of values. Is it okay? A finite set of values is called discrete values. The value should be finite in number. It is countable number. Okay. So otherwise, let me take the signal. Okay, I will take the signal. Oh, 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is 1.2, 2.2. What kind of signal is this? Can anybody tell me? What kind of signal is this?
Discrete time signal.
Discrete time. Why? What about amplitude? Is it not discrete?
Yes, sir.
Why it is not discrete then? Okay. So we'll discuss about everything later, but so let me go back to our course. If you transmit analog signals, it is called analog communications. If you transmit digital signal, it is called as digital communication. Okay. Now, so basically all the signals in nature are analog. Most of signals in nature are analog. Okay. So, but which is the most promising technology nowadays? Digital technology. Is it okay? So what we do here is, actually we take analog signals, we transform them into digital. We modify them as a digital and we transmit. Why? Because we have a advanced technology in digital. All our electronic devices works based on digital technology. Okay. Anyway, so if we transmit analog signals, it is called analog communication. If we transmit digital signal, it is called digital communication. Now we are studying both, how to transmit analog as well as digital signals. Okay. Now we will discuss everything later. So let us get into the topics. Now this is the basic block diagram of any communication system. I'm not saying it is only for analog or digital. You take any communication. First of all, what is the communication? It is a transfer of information from one place to other place. That is nothing but communication. Okay. Now, so these are the basic blocks of any communication system. Okay. First of all, we have a source. Source means which generates a message which need to be transmitted. Okay. Next, we have a transmitter. Okay. Next, we have a channel. In the channel, what happens? We get noise. Noise will be added in the channel. Next, we have a receiver. And the destination, anyway, is not that important. You take a mobile phone. Is it okay? So for the mobile phone, what is the source? Anyone? Source means
electromagnetic wave.
not that. So don't get into that. First of all, go to the basics. Source means which gives an information which need to be transmitted. In the mobile phone, what are you transmitting? Basically, basic phone, let us take. Using mobile, what is being transmitted?
Voice.
Your voice or speech. Isn't it? What are you transmitting using mobile? Voice. Your voice is being transmitted or speech. Who is the transmitter? Your mobile. Isn't it? So you give your voice to a mobile, it will transmit using antennas, using electromagnetic waves. Is it okay? And what is the channel? What is the channel? Your mobile, what is the channel? How it is transmitted to other place? Air. What is the channel? Air. Otherwise, the channel is wireless. There is a channel. There should be a channel for every communication system. So here the free space is a channel because we don't have wires. What is a channel? Free space. We're transmitting from that free space. Okay, using electromagnetic waves. Now what will happen? In that channel, you will get noise. What is the noise? It's an unwanted signal, or it is simply called as disturbance. While talking on a phone also, sometimes you get disturbances that we call as noise. Okay, who is the receiver? What is the receiver? Again, it is a mobile phone, because your mobile is acting as transmitter as well as receiver. Because so you are able to send the your voice through that mobile as well as you are able to receive the voice from that mobile itself. Okay, so let us take, you are making a phone call to your friend. There are two mobiles, one is yours, other one is your friend's. So it is dual role, you can think of like that. So this is the transmitter as well as the receiver. The two-way communication, no? Receiver. Okay. So transmitter simply we denote with TX. Receiver we denote with RX. Is it okay, all of you? Okay. Now, what else you transmit using mobile? Only voice, speech, that's it?
Messages.
X. Messages means what?
Photos.
Information, correct. Sir.
No, don't say information. Information is different types, no? So not only mobile, generally, what do you transmit from one place to other place? Okay. So one is voice. Using mobile, you transmit voice or speech. Okay. Next, what do you transmit?
Videos.
Okay, images. Very good. Video. To transmit video also, because see, remember, everything contains information. Your voice has some information, video has some information. Okay, now what does it transmit?
Images.
Yeah, images. Next,
files.
What
files?
Okay. What files contain?
Information like PDFs, what I mean to say. Means
what do they contain? I mean, they
text.
Contain text. What is the text? Some text, right? Lines. Alphabet. Yes. Is it okay, all of you? You are saying PDF file. What it contains? Alphabets, special characters, etc., etc. Isn't it? Okay, what else? That's it. You're missing one more important thing. what do you transmit? Images, video, one more thing is what? Audio. You transmit audio also. Okay. So in our day-to-day life, we transmit these many types of signals. All contain information. Okay. Now, so here, basically, these are generally for analog. They are analog in nature, generally. Okay. We may convert into digital. That is a different topic altogether. So we don't call them as a text. Separately, we don't call it a text or whatever it is. We call it as a data. Okay. Here, in analog communication, we transmit voice or also called as speech. We transmit audio, we transmit video, we can transmit images. But when it comes to digital communication, we transmit only data. We call it data. That's it. We don't. So why we call it data? Because in digital form, this is a digital signal. It is sequence of what? Ones and zeros. That is a digital signal. Okay. So in digital, we don't say it is this message or that message. Simply we say it is data. They transmit some data, which is a sequence of ones and zeros. Okay. Now, so don't bother about this data. We'll discuss later when we are discussing about digital communication. Anyway, so now we are dealing with analog communication. We transmit these type of signals from one place to other place. It is called a long distance communication. Okay. See, remember, we need these things to transmit from one place to other place, which are very far away from each other. Is it okay? Now, so let us go to the basics of this. Okay. Information source, which means a source which is giving information, right? Okay. So they are voice or speech, audio, video, data, etc. Images also. Correct? Next. Now, so everything that we are transmitting, everything that we are transmitting has got some frequency ranges. What do they got? They got some frequency ranges. So our voice, our speech has a frequency range of where to where? 300 hertz to 3300 hertz, or simply I can say 3.3 kilohertz. Okay. So when we speak something, we generate a sound signal. That sound signal has a frequency range of 300 hertz to 3.3 kilohertz. It is called for humans. Which means we can generate a sound signal whose frequency is from 300 to 3.3 kilohertz. Okay. Now this is the frequency range of our speech or our voice. So we have a vocal cord that will generate sound signals. That is called as speech or your voice. Okay. So it has got some frequency ranges. Now it is different for different gender actually. Okay. So male, female, will have more frequency? Which voice has more frequency?
Male.
No, no. Female voice has got more frequency. Okay. So anyway, whether it is male or female, our voice is in the range of 300 to 3.3 kilohertz. Now, so what is the bandwidth actually? What do you mean by bandwidth? So here our voice, so if I take our voice signal, it is from 300 to what? 3,300. What the bandwidth? Higher frequency minus lower frequency. So if you take that, how much you get? What is this band? 3,000. 3 kilohertz otherwise. Okay, but so what do we say is we keep some guard band. You know what is guard band? Some gap. So we say that, so the bandwidth of our voice is how much? 4 kilohertz, which means, so if you want to transmit your voice, we need a channel of bandwidth 4 kilohertz. Is it okay? So if at all you want to transmit your voice, we need a channel of bandwidth how much? 4 kilohertz. Remember this. Okay, so the logic is simple. Actually it is 3 kilohertz, they're keeping some gap, that's why we are making it as a, what is, how much is the gap? 1 kilohertz. So total is 4 kilohertz is the bandwidth of your voice. Okay, audio. Okay, first of all, what is the difference between voice and audio? What is the difference? Are they not same? What is audio? What is your speech or your voice? They are not same actually. Audio is what is audio means?
Like recording.
The sounds which we can hear. Audio means it is sound signal which we can hear. Voice means sound signal which we can produce. Okay, so it is nothing but hearing range. In humans, we, the humans, can hear a sound signal whose frequency is from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. We cannot hear a sound signal whose frequency is below 20 hertz as well as above 20 kilohertz. Okay, so this is our hearing capacity. So that is called, they are called audible sounds. What they're called? Audible sounds are called audio. Is it okay? Here, so simple example is, suppose in our surroundings, there are so many things that make sound. That is like vehicles, they make sound. Musical instruments, they make sound. Animals, they make sound. So in our surroundings, there are so many things that produce sound. But among them, we can only hear from 20 hertz to what? 20 kilohertz. This is the hearing capacity of our humans. Okay, so it is different for different animals. Is it okay? Suppose you take dogs. They can hear frequencies below 20 hertz also. You can take dolphins. They can hear sound signals whose frequency is more than 20 kilohertz also. But for human, this is a hearing range. Okay. So that's why people call it as audio release. In a movie functions, it is called what? Why is it called audio release? Because it contains so many frequencies in the range of 20 to 20 kilohertz. Those sounds are produced by musical instruments. Okay, so audio contains our voice also, as well as what it contains. It contains music. Music means that is something, sound something that is generated from instruments. Is it okay? Yes or not? Okay. Now, so that is the difference between voice and audio. Audio means what we can hear. Voice means what we can produce. Okay. Now, video. So we have video signal. So it has got this frequency range. Okay. From 0 to 4.5 megahertz. So these are all fixed frequencies. Is it okay? So lastly, data. So actually, data doesn't have any fixed frequency. It depends upon data rate. So we'll discuss about this data later. Sorry. Discuss about this later. Okay. As of now, we are dealing with these type of signals. So we want to communicate them from one place to other place. Okay. So far so good. I think any doubts? So shall we proceed? Okay.
No doubts.
Yeah, here. So here we have something called communication resources. First of all, what is a resource? So something very, very crucial for us. Today, let us take water. It is a resource. That's why we should use it properly. Is it okay? So there are so many natural resources which we have to use them carefully. Is it okay? In the same way, we have a resources in our communications. That is called communication resources, which means we have to use them carefully. Okay. What are they? Transmission power. The first communication resource is transmission power. So we should use them efficiently. Okay. So please remember this. Next one is bandwidth. Bandwidth and transmission power are two resources which should be used properly or carefully. Okay. Now, so that's why our aim is to minimize the usage of transmission power and bandwidth. As engineers, you must always try to use minimum power and minimum bandwidth to transmit your information. That should be our goal. Okay. So using minimum requirements or resources, we should be able to transmit more information. Okay. So they are simply called as communication resources. Use them properly or efficiently. So our goal is to minimize transmission power as well as bandwidth. Okay. So now next. Yeah. So this is the ancient communication methods. So our ancestors used to communicate using so many methods. Okay, this is one of the methods. What is the method? Pigeon post. You might have seen this in so many movies at least. Is it okay? What they will do? The pigeons are trained actually. Okay, so let us take, they want to pass some information from A to B, from place A to place B. What do they do? What they'll do? So here there are two things. One is message. Next one is carrier. Message, and the next one is carrier. What is the job of the carrier? It carries the message. Okay, so let us go back to the basic block diagram. So here we have a source, transmitter, channel, receiver. These are the basic block diagrams. Okay, please remember this. What are they? Source, transmitter, channel, receiver. The channel, we get Noise. Okay, anyway. Here, so where is the message? Where is the carrier? What is the message? What is the carrier? What is the message?
Letter is message.
This letter PGN. Or this paper. Who is carrying PGN. The paper?
PGN.
PGN.
This is a carrier. This is a message. Okay. So what do we do? So let me take this. Okay. So let me call this a transmitter. This is a receiver. So the transmitter, what are we doing? What are we doing? So we are keeping the message on the carrier. Yes or not? So here we are keeping this message on the carrier, or we are tying this message to the carrier. Okay, so we are transmitting. So at the receiver, what do you do? The receiver, what do you do? What other person will do? Okay, so it will reach the destination B. What you will do after reaching the destination?
Take the messages from the carrier.
You will take the message from the carrier. And what about carrier? He leave the carrier. Okay, so here the saddest part is we make use of the carrier to transmit our information, but we don't care about carrier. We use it and throw it away. Same thing, just like PGN. We are using PGN for our transmission. That's it. Okay, what do we do? First, we keep our message on the carrier at the transmitter. At the receiver, what do? We take our message from the carrier and we throw the carrier away. Is it okay? Now, so this is the same technique we use everywhere. Actually, we learn everything from our nature. Remember this. We don't invent anything. We just discover things. We learn everything from our nature. Okay. So till today, we follow same method. What do? We take our message, we keep it on the carrier, we transmit. Later, what do? We take message from the carrier, we throw the carrier away. Okay. So this is a simple technique you must know for communication. That's it. That's all. Okay. So we have made several improvements to this method only. This is a basic method for any communication system. Is it okay? So here what we do is, suppose you take a mobile phone. What is the message signal? Your voice. We keep your voice on the electromagnetic waves. We transmit. At the other side, what do? We extract the message from the electromagnetic waves and we throw away EM waves. So there we are using that EM waves as a carrier, which is carrying our original message signals. Is it okay? Right. Now, so we have a few things to remember. So here there will be a channel always. Channel means a path. What is required here? Your message. And we need a carrier to carry your message. So these are the basic things. Transmitter, receiver, channel, noise. Along with them, message and carrier. Okay. So what is the message here? It could be, your message could be what? It could be your voice. It could be video. It could be audio. It could be image. It could be anything among these. Okay. Now, so Now, so let us get into our technical terms. Now we have something called a baseband signal. It's also called a low pass signal. So that includes frequencies that are very near to zero or very close to zero. Okay, what is a baseband signal? A signal which contains what? Low frequencies. Low frequency means it could be zero or very near to zero. So it is also called what as? It is also called as low pass signal. You might be knowing low pass filter. How it is? It starts from zero, goes up to some frequency f. Low pass. It is passing low frequencies. Low pass signal means it has got very low frequencies. Low in the sense that? Low means what? It has got frequency ranges from 0 up to certain value. It could be 0 or very near to 0. It has got a signal which has got frequency ranges starting from 0 or starting from values very near to 0. That is called as a baseband signal. Please remember this. Baseband signal, a signal whose frequencies are starting from zero or starting from frequencies very near to zero. Okay, so can you tell me what is the frequency of a frequency range of voice? What? Where to where?
300 edges to 3300.
3300. Audio. This is voice, okay? This is voice. Okay, what about audio?
20 edges to 20 kilohertz.
20 edges to 20 kilohertz. What about video?
0 to 4.5 megahertz.
This is audio. What about video? 0 to 4.5 megahertz. So if you observe all these signals, either they are starting from zero or starting from frequencies very near to zero, maybe some hundreds of hertz. It is starting from 300, it is starting from only 20. Okay, so that's why all these signals are known as what signals?
Baseband signals.
Baseband signals. Okay, which means all our message signals are baseband signals. Because generally they start from zero or very near to zero, maybe some hundreds of hertz only. For example, our voice is starting from 300 and audio is starting from 20 hertz. Okay, so that is the meaning. So simply I can say that. So this is a typical spectrum, baseband signal. It is starting from 0, it is starting from 20. It should be like this. Okay. Now, message signal is usually a baseband signal. Okay. The message generally we transmit our baseband signals. What a baseband signal?
Starting from zero, near to zero.
Zero, near to zero. And so one more thing is, it has significant low frequency content. Means what? Our message signals has a distribution very close to zero frequency. Okay? It is a significant low frequency content. That's the meaning. They're starting from zero means what? They have some content at low frequencies. That's the meaning. They have some information at low frequencies. Is it okay? Your message signal is starting from zero means starting from zero means it has some information at low frequency also. That is the meaning. Or it has a some low frequency content or significantly low frequency content. Yeah, so we have one more signal, that is a pass band signal. But one more thing is pass band signal, base band and pass band. First of all, what is a band pass filter? How it will be?
Starts from zero or near to zero.
Band pass frequency. Not base band. Band pass filter. Something like this. Do you know what is low pass, high pass, band pass?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So it has a some frequencies, FC1, FC2. Is it okay? Anyway, so here just like band pass, we call a pass band signal. Okay, we call it as a pass band signal. Okay, so let me write here. First of all the message signals are base band signals. Next, we convert them into pass band signals by using something called modulation. What do we call as modulation? If you modulate, a base band signal becomes pass band. Okay, so what is a modulation? So there is a theorem in SNS, modulation theorem. What is that? Anybody? A modulation property, I can say. What is that? In SNS, there is a modulation property of Fourier transform. What is that? Do you know or not? Okay, so leave it. We'll discuss later. Now, pass band signal. When the base band signal is modulated to the carrier frequency for transmission, then it is called a pass band signal. Here, so observe very carefully. So, our voice, that is a base band signal. Okay, so it cannot travel longer distances. Okay, so all the signals in nature, they don't travel to longer distances. That's why we need to communicate them using some devices. Okay, how it is possible to transmit those signals to the longer distances? By using modulation. Something called modulation. So simply what happens is you take your mobile, you're transmitting your voice. So your voice cannot be transmitted directly. That's why what we do is we do something called modulation. In your mobile, there is a device called modulator. It takes your voice, it modulates, then it transmits. Okay, so what will happen? Other person will receive your modulated signal. What he will do? He will do demodulation. Means what? So is demodulation nothing but recovering your message signal, your voice back. Okay, so otherwise let me tell you something like this with a brief example. You take your mobile, otherwise take a transmitter is a receiver. Okay, so you want to, they are very far from each other. Okay, so there is a long gap between these two persons, person A and person B, let us take. So they want to communicate So if you talk directly, this person cannot listen. If the distance is more, you cannot listen, right? What we do? We need some devices. You take like mobile phone. Okay, it can be walkie-talkie. It can be anything. So what happens is, so here, suppose you are giving some information, your voice. Okay, that is a baseband signal. All the message signals are baseband signals usually. So what we do here is, we do something called as modulation. In a transmitter, we do something called as a modulation. What the modulation means? We keep our message signal on the carrier. As I told you just now, in the transmitter part, we keep our message on the carrier. That process is called modulation. Okay, so in the layman language, modulation means keeping your message signal on the carrier. Okay, we transmit. In the receiver, we have a reverse of modulation. What is what? Demodulation. What do you mean by that? We remove message from the carrier. That is called demodulation. Okay, so just remember, so transmitter and receiver are quite opposite of each other. Which means, if you are doing something in the transmitter, you should do opposite in the receiver. Suppose you are multiplying. Here you have to divide. Here you are adding. Here you have to subtract. So they are opposites. Okay. Here we do modulation. Here we do demodulation. Okay. Now. So, now what are we modulating? We are modulating our message signal. Message could be voice, audio, video, anything. Okay, but our message signals are baseband signal. Okay, which means, so we take our message signals, usually they are baseband. So if you modulate them, what do they become? They become
passband
signals, and these passband signals are transmitted using antennas. If it is wireless, we transmit those passband signals, and at the receiver, what do you receive? You receive passband signal only. Okay, then what happens? We do demodulation. Well, demodulation means what? Reverse of that, which means, so we take passband signal, we demodulate. What do we get? We get baseband signal. Okay, why it is so important? That is very, very important is your reproduction is very, very essential. Which means, suppose I am talking to you. You are listening my voice only. Correct? So that is called reproduction. Okay? Suppose I am sending something. Same thing should be received here. There should be more accuracy. Okay? If you are talking on a phone, your voice should be reaching that particular person, not other's voice. Yes or not? Okay. So if you are transmitting something, same thing should be received at the other side. It can be voice or it can be video, it can be audio, anything. So whatever you are transmitting, same thing should be reaching that particular destination. That is our aim. Okay. Suppose, so if that is not happening, there should be some error. Okay, so let us take simple thing. Suppose you are sending some text. How are you? I'm messaging like this. So other person should receive same thing. Okay. Suppose if there is error, it may, you may receive. If there is error, you will receive something like this. Okay, which means your information is not conveying properly at the receiver side. What is happening here? You are transmitting this signal, you are receiving this signal. So there is no reproduction. So in that case, there is no use of transmitting your signal, because you are transmitting something, the person is receiving something else. Then what is the use of transmitting? Okay, our aim is to get a faithful reproduction at the receiver side. Okay, there should be 100% accuracy. At least we try to get 100% accuracy. We get some errors. Nobody can avoid errors. Why we get errors? What is the reason? What is the reason?
Noise.
Who will generate noise?
Channel.
It gets added in the channel.
Only channel? Okay. So basically, yeah, channel is correct. The main culprit is the channel. Okay. So, but not only channel, our devices also produce noise. You take your mobile. In your mobile, there can be so many chips, so many things, right? So many diodes, so many transistors, everything. They also generate some noise. Not only channel, your mobile also a source of noise, isn't it? Because what is your mobile? It's a device which contains resistors, transistors, ICs, etc., etc. They do generate noise, isn't it? Okay, but okay. So we get more noise from the channel. That is true, but not only from the channel, from the devices also. Okay. Anyway, so that we discuss later. But so this is the one more aspect. Anyway, so we do modulation, and in the transmitter we modulate. In the receiver we do demodulation. Okay. What is modulation? Keeping the message on the carrier. What is demodulation? Removing the message from the carrier. Okay. So we are using the carrier and throwing it away, just like the pigeon in that case. Is it okay? Right. So if we basically all the message signals are baseband signal, if you modulate, they become passband signal. And what is the demodulation? Reverse, converting passband to baseband. Okay. Right. Now, so that is about these things. Yeah. So after modulation, baseband becomes passband. Okay, right. It is called frequency translation. That is very, very important. If you modulate, what is happening? Frequency is translated. This is very, very important. Let me explain. Suppose you take your voice. Okay. Suppose you are in the classroom. Okay. So we don't need any devices to communicate. Agreed or not? So if you are very close to each other, we don't need mobile phone to talk to your friend. Agreed or not? We can talk directly. Why? Because we are very close to each other. So we are very far away from each other, then we need some devices. Okay. So suppose if the distance is more, your voice cannot travel more distance. Why? Because it has got very low frequency. Your voice still is baseband signal, a low frequency signal. It cannot travel to longer distances. That's why what do we do? We increase the frequency of your signal, your voice signal. What do we do means frequency translation. Suppose your frequency is F1. we increase this f1 plus some fc and then we transmit. Okay, how to increase the frequency of the signal with help of what? Carrier. What is fc? Carrier frequency. So what happens is, so we keep our voice on the carrier, then what will happen? The carrier has got some frequency and your signal has got some frequency. So now the total frequency becomes more, then you will transmit directly. Okay, so it is called frequency translation. Frequency translation. So can you tell me how to translate frequency? How to translate frequency? See, these are all things in S&S. Okay, let me ask you a question. What is the Fourier transform of x of t into cos 2 pi fct? X of t is a Fourier transform, x of f. Anyone?
Yes, sir.
I am asking basic question from your S&S. This is called modulation property. Anybody?
Sir, sir.
Your voice is not audible. X of?
X of omega plus 2 pi fc.
Okay.
Plus x of omega minus 2 pi fc by 2.
Is it, this is what you want to say? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So here, what is happening here? What is happening here?
Frequency modulation.
Not modulation, frequency translation.
Okay, sir.
So this is nothing but modulation, nothing else. This property is called as modulation property. Okay, so okay, right, this is correct, but I don't think this is 1 by 2. It is, I think, pi. Am I right? You check it. So what happened here? What happened here? Frequency shifting has happened. Here, it is x of f or x of omega. Then what happened? X of omega minus omega c. It has shifted to omega c. It is, there is a frequency translation. Okay? Okay, just now you told me the answer. Okay, right. X of t has a Fourier transform, x of omega. So x of t into cos omega ct as a Fourier transform of what pi into x of omega plus omega c plus x of omega minus omega c, isn't it? Now what is omega plus omega c? What is this? This is the shifted versions of x of omega. Suppose x of omega is there. X of omega minus omega c means what? There is a frequency shifting of how much? Omega c to the right hand side. Okay. Suppose if x of omega is something like this. whatever x of omega minus omega c should be. This is, let us take 0. This is minus b, this is b.
Sir, it's not pi, sir, it's 1 by 2 only.
1 by 2? You just check it once. Okay. Now, so this is x of omega. What about x of omega minus omega c? What happened here? What is happening here? Frequency translation.
Shifting is happening.
Shifting is happening. To where?
Omega c.
Then what happens? This is omega c. What about this? What is this? Omega c minus b. What about this?
Omega c.
This is 0. Here it is 0. What about x of omega plus omega c? Means what? To the left hand side. Here you get something like this. Okay. So what is happening here? You assume this as a message signal. Why? Because it has got low frequency. It is starting from 0. Okay. This is nothing but baseband signal. After modulation, it is not starting from 0. It is starting from some frequencies, high frequencies. Omega c minus b to omega c plus b. It is called pass band signal. Why? Because it is just like low pass signal. Low pass filter. It is like what filter?
Band pass filter.
Band pass filter. Simply we call pass band. Base band, pass band. This is after modulation. So modulation means what? Frequency translation. Here, what is the center frequency? 0. Here, what is center frequency of the signal? WC. Okay. Now, it is nothing but modulation. But I told you, modulation means keeping the message on the carrier. Where is the carrier? This is a message signal. And this is the carrier. So here modulation means multiply the message signal with the carrier. That's it. So this property is known as modulation property. Okay. So we'll come to this later. Now, so what is the time? Is it over?
11:55, sir.
Okay, I think we should stop here now. Is it okay? Right, ma'am, stop here. Thank you. Thank you.